Now let's discuss what we'll do in the first lesson. We'll define AC, compare DC to AC waveforms, and we'll show how an AC waveform is generated. We'll then take a close look at the AC waveform and see how we describe it with the terms period and frequency. We will begin by giving you a definition of AC. AC is the abbreviation for alternating current. Alternating current is a current which changes in both magnitude and direction. The term magnitude refers to the amount of current flowing in the circuit. The term direction refers to the direction in which current flows in the circuit. This simple DC circuit may be used to simulate alternating current. The circuit consists of a variable DC power supply, a resistor, and a galvanometer. Here's our circuit built up in the laboratory. Here's the DC supply, the resistor, and the galvanometer. The galvanometer is an ammeter with a center scale value of 0 amperes. If electron current flows in the circuit in a counterclockwise direction, the meter will deflect to the left. If the electron current flows in a clockwise direction, the meter will deflect to the right. With the circuit connected as shown, electron current flow will be in a counterclockwise direction. As the power supply voltage is increased, the galvanometer needle deflects to the left up to some maximum current value. As the voltage is decreased to 0 volts, electron current flow in the circuit decreases to 0 amperes. At this point, we have produced a current flow which changes in magnitude. This meets one of the 2 specified criteria for alternating current. To meet the other criterion, a change in direction, the polarity of the power supply can be reversed. Notice that electron current should now flow in a clockwise direction. As the power supply voltage is increased, the galvanometer needle deflects to the right up to some maximum value. As the voltage is decreased to 0 volts, electron current flow in the circuit decreases to 0 amperes. Let's now see how this alternating current may be represented in graphical form. Notice that the axes of this graph are specified to plot current versus time. Time is plotted on the horizontal or x-axis. Current is plotted on the vertical or y-axis. The vertical axis is divided into a positive current value above the x-axis and a negative current value below the x-axis. This polarity designation is used simply to differentiate between directions of current flow. For this application, current flow in a counterclockwise direction will be designated a positive current. Current flow in the opposite or clockwise direction will be designated a negative current. You should realize that the polarity and direction selections are arbitrary. In the initial configuration, current flowed in a counterclockwise direction. As the voltage was increased and decreased, current flow increased and decreased. Note that the direction of the current remained the same. Only the value of the current changed. Current in this direction is plotted in the top half, or positive current, area of the graph. With the connections reversed, current now flows in a clockwise direction. The current in the negative or clockwise direction now increases, then decreases, as shown here. This is a graph of one type of an AC waveform. Notice the 2 distinguishing characteristics of this waveform. First, there is a change in current value. In this example, the current value is constantly changing. Second, the direction of current flow has changed. This change in direction is indicated by the waveform crossing the x-axis into the negative area of the graph. If these 2 criteria are met, the waveform can be categorized as an AC waveform. If there is current flow in a circuit, a difference in potential or voltage must be present. The polarity of the voltage must change to cause the current to change direction. A voltage that causes an alternating current is called an AC voltage.